us express absolute confidence in the security system of our country. This is what the president is saying. The House of Chiefs in Volta region, the Awomafia, the Togbi Siri, prominent and eminent Ghanaians have condemned this action. Duke, there is a thin line between terrorists and secessionists. The worst we can do to this matter at this critical point of our national development is to look at it through the lens of politics, religion, ethnic or tribal lines. We destroy the whole case. It is a terrible matter. I have had occasion where I listened to the minister, Honorable Kwadwo Opon-Nkrumah, and he says that people believe the security services must exercise a certain degree of high-handedness in the management of this situation. Again, would you want to crush a fly with a sledgehammer? Or you would want to go on the path of negotiation, consultation, and bargaining, granting them a listening ear? The opposition would want to whip up political sentiment and ask questions as to whether or not the security services have been on top of their job. Let me tell you what happens. Do you think the men and women on the day had the ulterior motive of just going to block roads? Look at the installations, critical national installations around the enclave. Okay? Akwesogbo Dam, the whole central market, Akwese, Bon, Volta River Authority, before you take the right detour heading towards Ho. Okay? The point is that we are told by the security operatives of this country, they had a more terrible and terrifying desire, which was thwarted by the National Security Operative, and that landed them on the street, blocking the roads. I have every right to express confidence in the leadership of the security services of this country. The president is saying, we trust in the leadership of the armed forces. Volta Regional Minister chairs the Regional Security Council. The information he's privy to, I am not. When he tells us the men originally did not even plan going to block the roads, they had terrible plans in place. But when we picked the intelligence and the tip off, that led to we thwarting their effort before they went to block roads. But the point is,
the argument would then suggest that we've been on top of this issue for some time. But the fact that the element of terror, the fact that people there's even a person who lost his life on Friday, are we not patting ourselves on the back for a situation that is not so good?
Duke, I do not think we are celebrating the successes we have attained as far as the management of this situation is concerned. However, politicians will not dictate the pace and the degree of involvement of our security couples in this matter. Let me tell you something that happened in 1994 in Rwanda.
The genocide.
The Tutsis and the Hutus. It was just an airplane flying that carried the Burundi president and the president of Rwanda. Okay, that was shot down. Prior to that, there had been ethnic and political undertones.
Which
the point I'm trying to establish is that
communities.
No, you don't blame international community. When you have a secessionist activity that started in the year 2016, they just held a press conference and called for secession. 2016. The president did not do anything. Today, the president is accused of looking on quietly. Now there is an approach. Let us keep quiet and then wake up one morning where the security services of our country will dictate a new line of direction and say, let us put a state of emergency on the whole of the enclave where the problems seem to persist. Blackout as part of the security measures. What are people going to say? High-handedness. Now that the security services are gradually and incrementally following the activities of the people to determine who is sponsoring them, to determine who are the bigger bodies behind them, and to determine their next line of action, people are saying they are being slow. There is an alternative. If you don't approach this situation from a well-established best practice point of view, you will end up creating an unnecessary matter out of this situation. Listen to what happened in the days of Boko Haram, when the Nigerians openly slaughtered the leader. A lot of young men got involved because they saw a sense of martyrdom and heroism over there. Let us trust in the direction the security services of this company, of this country is giving out. But for me, my brother Adam and I, very young men in politics, let me sound this caution to all of us and everybody watching us. The matter over there is more serious. Let us not politicize it. It is terrible. Let's give it a national attention. View it from a nationalistic perspective, because as I speak to you now, the best we have heard from the people of Ghana is the position taken by the Anglo chiefs. Let us support that position, condemn the activity of these secessionists. And I will say it on authority, there is only a thin line between secessionists and terrorists. We are certain on a volatile case. So the volatility deepens when politicians get involved and seem to score political capital out of it. That political capital may give you momentary pleasure, but it's destructive and has embedded in it terrible nation wrecking tendencies.
Hi there, we hope you enjoyed the show.
Make sure to subscribe, like, comment, and share with your friends.
This is Breakfast Daily on City TV.
Join the Breakfast Daily team Monday through Fridays from 7:30 a.m. to 10. Join us for breakfast daily, only on City TV.